Number two, you had to stay focused up. Right, number three, you had to stay in position in order to get ready for the great shift.
Yeah.
It's a great shift that was to take place, people of God. But we got to get in position. We got to get prepared. Come on, somebody. We got to stay focused on God. Come on, get ready for the shift. Anybody ready for the great shift? Ready to shift in your marriage.
Yeah.
Ready to shift in your finances.
Yeah.
Ready to shift in your children.
Yeah.
But then some of you need to get in position. Some of you need to let God prepare us. Come on, somebody. Follow his instruction. How do I just say to them? How do I do this? Stay on your knees. Stay on your knees to get what you need. Some of you need to build our prayer life up. Some of you need to build our relationship up. How bad do you want it?
Jesus.
Going to battle. See, some of us, we need to keep our mouths shut when folks start talking about us and saying, oh, I'm going to tell the last word. I'm going to go over and tell them, no, you need to keep your mouth shut and let God work that out. Some of us are always messy. Messy and stuff. That's why you can't get blessed. That's why you can't get delivered. Because you're always messing with some stuff. If you just let go and let God have it, it must have seemed strange to the Israelites that instead of going to battle, they were going to march around the city for a week. But this was God's plan. See, God has a plan for every one of our lives.
Amen.
But we got to get in position, people.
Amen.
Position what God wants us to be.
Thank you, Lord.
We're all over the place. Think it's all about us. Just because you can hoop and you can preach and everybody shouting, going through all this emotion stuff.
Afraid,
but I'm not afraid.
Jesus.
I've been on the fast for 21 days for this conference. And God said, you follow my instructions. coaching. Yeah. Whoever don't like it, so be it. I still love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Witchcraft demons is the tool in the church. And God said, we got to recognize this spirit and do something about it. The door of the cloud.
Jesus.
Come from behind the pulpit and go out there and get these people.
Right.
Yes.
That's right.
Yeah. Is that in Mark? Am I right, child? Is that,
yes,
is that in the book of Mark?
Yes,
ma'am. And the man brought the little boy to Jesus and said that, why the disciples couldn't do this thing? Is this type come about prayer and fast?
Right.
We ain't doing enough prayer and fast with praying. I'm talking about the fast that God has chosen. Come on. Right. The fast that God has chosen. You're going to hear from God. Hey. You're going to hear from Him. Hey. He's going to be talking to you when you fast and pray. Fumbling all at the mouth, cringing at the teeth. These demons is real.
They are.
Read the book.
Yes.
I'm just trying to help somebody.
Yes.
Read the book.
Yes.
They're flowing all around here, on our job, in our home, in the church.
Right.
Read the book.
Yes.
They read.
Yes.
Don't have any witness in the house.
Jesus.
Amen. Breathe. Breathe.
Oh, she shouldn't have said that. Why she talking about those demons? Because they real. And you on Facebook, you probably showing all your tail and stuff and drinking and going on. What? Come on, somebody. I thought she. Come on now. So I can't say what the Holy Ghost is saying. You can get on Facebook.
Breathe. Breathe. Preach. Help a Holy Ghost.
My God.
Yeah.
Number three, study the Word of God. 2 Timothy 2 and 15 says that if you study the Word of God, you will not be ashamed. It also says that studying the Word will give you the ability to rightfully divide the
Amen.
Word of truth.
Amen.
We got to get in the Word of people, God.
Amen.
We don't want to study the Word of God.
Amen.
We want to quit the Sunday morning thing. Come on, y'all. That's the only time that you open your mouth. Because God will examine what kind of worker we have been for Him. We should build our lives on His Word and build His Word into our lives. We got to build, y'all.
Right.
When we study, we're building the Word in our lives, y'all.
Right, right.
We got to get it on the inside.
Right.
Hallelujah. We got to work the Word, y'all. Tell somebody, say, work the Word.
Work the Word.
Hallelujah. Then when you see that devil coming up and all this and all these spirits and people acting crazy, you don't have some Word and you begin to stop praying.
That's right.
You have to say the Lord in the name of Jesus. Because there's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Break old ties and souls ties. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature.
All right.
Old things is have passed away.
Right.
Behold, all things have become new.
Right.
There should be a change somewhere.
Somewhere.
My God, you said you've been saying that since you've been a little girl, a little boy.
My God.
And you change? God said He'll know you by the fruits.
Woo!
But He said it.
But
you said it.
You bear good fruit or bad fruit.
Mm-hmm.
When you go to the grocery store, you want some pretty red apples in there, right?
Uh-huh.
You ain't buying no right now. Come on now. Come on, somebody. So we want some good fruit, isn't that right?
Amen.
So what are you bearing? Either good fruit or either bad fruit.
Amen.
God said, you'll know nobody's fruit and what they bear. Nobody's judging.
Say,
yeah. Yeah. You're judging me. Nobody, I'm not
I'm
judging you.
Fruit.
I know that I see the heaven from everybody. I'm not judging you.
Amen.
Where are the good fruit these days?
Yeah.
Where are the good fruit? Where are the people see us, all things in our lives appear new. You can't be the new you and the old you at the same time. It's a choice. Make up your mind. Serve the Lord, you're going to serve the devil.
Amen.
You know about it, God ain't going to twist your arm.
No, he's not.
Make you do nothing. It's up to you.
Right.
How do I stay the liver? God, your number five, God, your thought life. You are only as the liver as you think you are.
Woo.
So you got to let the devil know that I am the liver. Bondages were cigarettes and cocaine. After I was set free by the power of Jesus Christ, the devil would place images before me to make me think I was still bound by these addictions. What is your addiction? Everybody have an addiction. He told me I was still a junkie.
Wow.
The devil be saying that to y'all, but you still listen, you still ain't. But I know I was free.
Right.
When Satan spoke, I heard him from afar because God's voice was so much.